Welcome to the Legends and Lore, a spooky podcast by the sixth graders at OPE. My name is Mallory.
This is Michaela.
Today I'm going to be talking about the legend of Charlie. Stay tuned and find out more. This podcast was recorded using iPads, and the music is from iMovie.
Once upon a time, there was a kid named Charlie. He had blonde hair, a whole butt taste in fashion, and he also had a giant nose that had moles on it. It was gross. He also had lots of problems, like he was mean, he caused lots of trouble, and he treated people horribly. Of course, his dad was a therapist who loved him a lot, no matter how awful he was. But his mother, who is a professional model who was about 6 feet tall and perfect hair, at least that's what she said. One thing you should know about it is that she hated him. She always wanted a baby girl. Now she's stuck with me forever. One day, Charlie's mother took him to the mountain. Bathrooms were all the way up in the mountains, so they walked all the way up. It took them forever just to get up there. When they realized they were in the woods, now we're close to the bathroom.
Finally, when they got up there were no bathrooms. So he just had to wait. And the mom was standing right at the edge of the cliff. So she called Charlie over. There they were, at the edge of the cliff. When the mom whispered into Charlie's ear, "This is better for the both of us." Then she pushed Charlie off the cliff. And a few years later, the mother had a beautiful baby girl named Chelsea, and she was perfect in every way. She had beautiful blonde hair with curls. She wore a beautiful blue dress with little hearts on it. She wanted to be a fashion model just like her mother. One day, Chelsea snuck out of the house, and the mom went out to try to get her. When she followed her to the Mountain Woods Park. The mom looked everywhere just to find Chelsea. The mom looked everywhere. Then all of a sudden, she found herself where the bathroom stood, where Charlie died. All of a sudden, Chelsea showed up right behind her, and she whispered into the mother's ear, "Don't push me off the wall again, Mommy. I'm perfect now." The end. Now, Super Slime Studios, all fun and homemade slime, minutes and mess. After doing your ingredients into the slime maker, you simply turn the handle and watch as slime magically starts to form. Add glitter and paint, add your slime flavors, and the best part, it includes everything you need to get slimy. The next way in slime making, no matter the battles, includes slime marker, make it, stretch it, and squish it, ages 6+.